سلام و خدا تو ویشی ول و داد تو تلو از بیوتیفل سمال ستوری اباد هشم پروتکشن when you believe in Hashem and you are connected to Hashem and you feel Hashem he is on you HaKadosh Baruch Hu don't let you down when Hashem is with you when Yezoi are with him I mean it's not fair that he is with you you are not with him anyway most of the time even that you are not with him he is with you otherwise we'll die This is Hashem. But one thing I have to tell you, that to feel Hashem, you have to do something. I mean, if you want to eat, you must have food. If you don't have food, you cannot eat. I mean, to believe in Hashem, there is a work that you have to do. My friend, there is a man here in Israel, this beautiful story, that never, never, never spend Shabbat outside his house. Never, never, never. He lives in one of the villages not far away from Gaza. And he don't believe in God. He don't believe, he doesn't do nothing. But he wasn't the boss, coming from somewhere, home. He find a newspaper, a religious newspaper. Well, there is a, you know, preparation for Simchat Torah. And at the beginning, he threw the paper. But he saw a name, he saw that some, a name of somebody in the paper. There was an article with a name. So it was like his name and his name, his family name. So he took and he read there a story about somebody that he was in the Shoah. A story about a person that he was in the Shoah and they had a big miracle in the Shoah. With the zichut of Simchat Torah. I mean, a story that a man, a story about Simchat Torah. That the day that they were supposed to kill him, the Nazi on Simchat Torah, that day they started, you know, they arrived, the American arrived, I don't know what happened. And then he had a miracle. So that man, he saw the article, and he thought, he said, what is this Simchat Torah? What is this Simchat Torah? He's a Jew, he's Israeli, but he doesn't know, he's not religious. He doesn't know what is this Simchat Torah. And he went home, and he told his wife, what do you think if we go to Jerusalem, there is a, We see what it is Simchat Torah like. And she started laughing. She says, since when we are talking about Simchat Torah? Since when? We never talk about Simchat Torah. What is it Simchat Torah? What is it Torah? They are very far away. They don't do no kippur, nothing. They even, I don't want to say, the home is not kosher or not. So he told her, look, at least, we do an experience. We're Jew anyway. So he told her, your grandparents, they were in Auschwitz, and they were killed. My grandparents too, they were killed. So look, I read this story. So let's go and see what's in Simchat Torah. And they started to make some plan, and they went to Jerusalem. They went to a hotel, where there is a hotel, kosher hotel, with a Simchat Torah, ba 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 ba. Well, of course, good dinner, and of course, there was some dancing there. There was some Divrei Torah, and everything. They were okay. They're not used to all this. He told his wife, "Well, anyway, tomorrow we go back home. We don't need to stay here. Tomorrow morning, we take the car, we go back home. In the morning, the village from where they're from was the, one of the first. They killed most of them. And of course, in his house, they killed the dog, they killed the, you know, a disaster in his house. And today, he said, Baruch Hashem. Baruch Hashem, sometimes you give a chance to Hashem, and Hashem give you a chance. Hashem bless you. Thank you. And I pray to Hashem for miracles for all our brothers and sisters here in Eretz Israel and for our soldiers. Amen.